The fifth word. After this, aware that everything was now finished, in order that the scripture might be fulfilled, Jesus said, "I thirst." There was a vessel filled with common wine. So they put a sponge soaked in wine on a sprig of hyssop and put it up to his mouth.
Minsan po, nagbigay ako ng retreat sa Tagaytay. Habang ako'y nagbibigay ng retreat, the admin, yung staff nila, pumunta sa akin at ang sabi, "Father, meron tayong emergency. Baka pwede kang kumausap." So sa ganong cases, I know usually kung anong mga kaso yon. Pagpunta ko sa kanilang counseling room, merong isang binatang nakasalampak. Sa unang tingin, normal yung bata. Pero nung pagdating ko, pinakilala ako, nung nagmano yung bata at tumayo, sabi ko, in normal circumstances, he could have been an actor. Tall, dark, young, handsome. But when I looked straight into his eyes, I realized something was wrong. There was sadness, there was pain. At ang unang tanong ko sa kanya, "Kapatid, kumain ka na ba?" Ang sagot, "Father, hindi ho ako nagugutom, pero nauuhaw ho ako." Tapos naupo na kami, nagkwento siya, anong nangyari. I realized that like many young people of today, ganun ang kaso niya. The family is there, but he felt alone. Both parents are successful, but sabi nga niya, they are good providers. But what I need are parents who could listen to me. Parents who could provide guiding and loving presence. In other words, he was a person who was seeking for a relationship. Something more than physical. Meron siyang girlfriend of 4 years, yet often he would say, "I felt alone. My girlfriend was simply for a show and only to satisfy his temporary carnal desires." And many times, nagiwalay sila. Many times, nagkabalikan. Parang popoy at basya lang. And he would, every time mag-away sila, he would lavish her with gifts. At tuwing nagkabalikan, back to the old self. He has friends, sabi nga niya, who stayed with me even for many hours, but would leave when the hangover is gone or the effects of party drugs subsided. He was seeking for something more. Yet, he was young and proud. He has rich parents with him. He has a beautiful girlfriend. He has friends and hangers-on. He is studying in a known university. He has riches and possessions. Yet, he was lacking something. He still has his own cravings and yearnings, just like any young people. And that is the very reason why we talk. Kasi sabi niya, he had tried many times to find something, that something that is more, that is something which is beyond the physical, that is something that would last. But always, he ended up short. And his solution to end his life. He was not hungry. He was thirsty. Not for an ordinary water, but for something more. And like the story of the Samaritan woman that Jesus encountered in Jacob's well, this young man was seeking also for something that would last forever. This young man was seeking for something that only Jesus can satisfy. Whoever drinks the water I give them will never thirst. Indeed, the water I give them will become in them a spring of water welling up to eternal life. I thirst, the words of Jesus. Probably for many of us, the same words. I thirst. I thirst for the love of my family. I thirst for the acceptance of people around me. I thirst, even for us religious, we can say, I thirst for the appreciation of those around me. We all thirst, but we know that that thirst can only be satisfied by Jesus. And so we ask, how can Jesus satisfy our needs? Kapatid, we are also challenged to be like Jesus to one another. When this young man opened up himself to me, he shared even his deepest pain, his deepest hurt, his deepest fears. Sabi nga niya sa akin, Father, I seem to have no one. And I assured him, you have Jesus. I shared to him the story of Jesus and his encounter with a rich young man. The rich young man could not let go of his possessions, and yet Jesus looked at him with so much love. Kasi sabi ko sa kanya, kapatid, at this very moment when you feel so down, Jesus is looking with you, looking at you with so much love. Don't worry. Mahal ka ng Diyos. Sabi niya, Father, natatakot ako. Sabi ko, kapatid, hindi lang naman ikaw ang natatakot. Lahat tayo may takot. That is why it is important that you allow that fear to be shared to Jesus. Sabi nga, ang anong mabigat, kung binibitawan, gumagaan, lalo na kay Kristong ating kaibigan. Yes, this young man has fears. He has been rejected many times over, and he's afraid that even God would reject him. Kaya nga sabi ko sa kanya, kung ikaw nga, tinanggap ko, ano pa kaya ang Diyos? Mas mabait sa akin yon. Ano pa kaya ang Diyos? Mas mapagmahal sa akin yon. Ano pa kaya ang Diyos? Mas higit pa sa akin yon. In the end, his last words, Father, please pray for me. Ang sagot ko sa kanya, kapatid, we all need prayers. Let us pray for one another. Recently, I gave a retreat in the same retreat house in Tagaytay. And I was told, sabi sa akin nung staff, same staff na tumawag sa akin, Father, he just graduated college. This young man, he just graduated college. I thirst. Jesus is one with us in our own struggles. Like us, he too has his own yearnings. It may be physical, pero still it's a human need. Ang tanong lang sa atin dito, when people would cry out to us, telling us they are thirsty, how do we respond? Katulad din ba nung sundalo, no, who got a sponge, soaked it in bitter wine and gave it to Jesus? O sa bagay, millennials na ang karamihan. Kapag nauuhaw, Starbucks na bang ibibigay? Sabi nga ni Cardinal Tagle, no! Mas masarap pa rin ang pahimis na kape ng Amadeo. Diba? Hindi ho ako nagiinom ng kape. Kaya probably I can offer perhaps soda or tea, mineral water. What can we offer? Can we offer ourselves to quench the thirst of others? I suppose we could. Only if we have received the eternal water from Jesus. Only if we are connected with Jesus. For when we are connected with Jesus, any action we make, any words or word we say would always be rooted in our relationship with Jesus. I thirst for love of people around me. I thirst for appreciation of people around me. I thirst perhaps for the embrace of my husband or of my wife. I thirst for so many things. All these thirsts are human in origin. But if we have Jesus, everything would be okay. Mga kapatid, bilang panghuli, we are always challenged to be Jesus alive for one another. Yes, we have our limitations. Yes, we have our shortcomings. Yes, we have our own pains and struggles. But always, it is in our pain, it is in our woundedness that Jesus brings healing. And so when we receive the healing of Jesus, we too are encouraged to bring healing to others. God bless.